Let us continue with our lesson, and today we'll go and learn about the integer data type. So let's go and create a variable. So I'll create a, let's say var, and I'll say as my int 1, and I'll explicitly mention it as integer data type is equals to 0, and I will also create another one, my int, and I will say 2, and explicitly mention it as integer data type is equals to 0. And also let me create another one of my int, and I will mention a data type over here and just give a value of a 0. So whenever you create a variable and declare a data type, so it's make sure you have some space after you create some variable name, because it's the code is more readable over here. So whenever we have a variable name and an integer or a byte data type, integer sort data type, so make sure you have one space after your variable name. So that way you can, it's more easy for you to read that what is a data type, and you don't get mixed up with a variable name of data types when you have or don't have a space either between the variable name and a data type. So make sure you have one space over here for just a code readability, and it's a good practice for you guys. And here we have one explicit, we have never mentioned explicitly that this is a integer data type, and we just say that var create a variable name and assign a value of 0. So by default, whenever you create a variable and assign numbers or integer value to it, it will by default will become a integer data type. So you don't have to explicitly mention, like here we have explicitly mentioned, but here we don't have to explicitly mention that this is an integer data type. So whenever we assign a value over here, let's say 10 20 100, or any numbers that you assign over here, it will by default will convert it to the integer data type. So here it's by default will become an integer data type. So if you are confused, you can just click over here, and from your keyboard what we can press is a control plus shift plus B. So it will take you to the primitive data type. So what kind of data type it is, so it will take you to there. So this is a primitive data type and it has an integer. So similarly, if you go over here and click on the variable name and press the control shift and B from your keyboard, it will take you to the primitive data type of a sort. And you can also do for the same as a byte, control shift and B, it will take you to the primitive data type of byte. So that way we can know what kind of data type it's actually. So this is by default now integer data type, so we don't have to explicitly mention that this is a integer data type. So let's go down over here and let's assign some value to it, and I'll say as the int, and which is equals to of a 32 bit. By default it's a 32 bit in size, and which is equals to 4 byte. So 32 is 8 times 8 is 32 bit, so which is a 4 byte over here. So we can see it's double the size of the sort. The size is sort is of 16, and if you see int is about 32 bits. So I can say that my int one, so my int one, and let me assign this my int 3, so that way we have 1, 2, and 3. So my int one, I'll say assign a value of 1000 over here. Let me go down over here. It's I think that 1000 is a 10,000, and let's go down over here and create another assign a value for our my int 2 is equals to minus let's say 10,000, and we have a my int. So my int we can assign any values. So if you go my int 3 is equals to of let's say value of 2000. So that's it can hold integer value is the size of the 4 byte, and it can hold a value of both negative and positive. So let's go and say f of our range over here. Our range is equals to from it can give a hold the range of minus, we can say as a 2 to the power of, let me say 2 to the power of 31, and sorry 31 over here, to the value of equals to positive number of 2 to the power of 31 minus 1. So that is the range of the integer data type, and it can be of SIG and EBCIN numbers. So which means that it is can hold both a negative as well as a positive space, negative and positive numbers, can hold both negative and positive number. And you can see the range is of 2 to the power of 31, minus 2 to the power of 31 to the 2 to the power of 31 and positive sign. So if you want to get an exponent of what is the value from this one, you can just go to the Google, and let me go to the Google and search for the exponent calculator. Exponent calculator. Okay, so we have this one. Let me show you that. So when we have exponent calculator, you can just take any of the link and just go to the exponent calculator. So the base is of 2. We are calculating. So base is 2, and the exponent we have of what is the exponent? We have a 31, right? 31. The exponent of 31, and we can just calculate, and that should give us this value, which is some 2 billion something, right? 2,147,486,648 something. So that's the range that it can hold, and this is on a negative side, and positive side would be minus 1, which is a 647 it should be. So it's on a scientific number that we can also make use of. So that's the exponent calculator. So that's it on range and the integer data type. So if we never mention the value over here, like a default data type over here, it should be by default will be of an integer data type. So same as over here, if you never mention a sort data type, and if you want to create a sort data type, but if you never mention it by default, it will become an int data type. So that's it for this lesson, and we'll continue with our lesson on the next video. Till then, have a great day.